that you have a hide after your comments.
Tonight, under attack, the politician accused of racism. The police suspension that will strip $1 million from the budget. ATM fees and the new threat from the big banks. And reported to federal police, singer Brian McFadden's controversial flight.
This is the 10 Evening News with Sandra Sully.
Good evening. First tonight, some breaking news, and the child at the centre of the racism row that has dominated federal politics will be allowed to stay in Australia. The 9-year-old orphan from Iran lost his parents during the Christmas Island boat tragedy in December. Here's Immigration Minister Chris Bowen just moments ago on 6pm with George Negus.
He and the family who've been looking after him on Christmas Island can be released into the community, as I've been working on for several days.
Released to where?
Released to a home in Sydney, and that's everything. We had to find a house, accommodation to put him.
When will that happen?
That'll happen next week. I hope to finalise the paperwork tomorrow and he'll be back on mainland next week.
Immigration Minister Chris Bowen there. Well, the federal opposition denies that it's anti-Muslim after reports its immigration spokesman had urged the coalition to cash in on community fears. Today, Scott Morrison came under attack from angry protesters.
Denounced as a political opportunist, there was little harmony on Harmony Day.
I think it's a disgrace that you're here, that you have a hide after your comments.
Scott Morrison trying to prove he's anything but after reports he urged Shadow Cabinet to capitalise on fears about Muslim migrants.
I don't comment on Shadow Cabinet here or anywhere else. All I can say is the gossip reported today does not reflect my views.
An absolute travesty of Scott's position, and we will always have a non-discriminatory immigration policy.
The Prime Minister says Mr Morrison should be peeled back.
He's not prepared to follow him down this grubby path, and Mr Morrison should go to the back bench.
It's what I would have expected of Scott Morrison. I think that is politics at its very, very basis.
After being plagued by rifts over asylum seekers and reports front benches are jostling for each other's jobs, this is the last thing the coalition needs. But Mr Morrison's alleged comments have gained some support, but from where the coalition doesn't want it.
They're finding that our policies and what we're saying is more popular with the Australian people.
Amanda Hart, 10 News.